You know what I'm gonna try? Hold on. Something I've been wanting to try. Oh, don't shake it up. Gloss, medium, and varnish. I don't know if it's already open. It is not open. Let's cut this. Or can I trim it? I bet I can trim it afterwards, can I? Here's the plan. I'm going to use this varnish with the paint. Oh, I'm so excited. I don't know why I didn't think of this doing this earlier, because all these guys have been watching on YouTube do this, especially. Shout out to Dan Nelson. Check out his channel. He is amazing. But he does these washes with a varnish. He uses something else. This is what I'm chosen to start with. But I think that would be a good addition to what I do, because I work mixed media, and a nice coat of varnish or sealant on top of dried watercolor, pastel, oil pastels, chalk pastels, charcoal, all that stuff. Let me get this off. Songs came on. Gorillaz. We Got the Power, the only good song on that album. This comes out like, just use us a little bit. So I don't think I need much. And let's just mix this a little bit more. Also uses just regular house paint brushes. And that's what I'm gonna go for. I use more paint. More water. I feel like a mad scientist. It's alright, because this, I might just use this on a. You know what, before we use this on this, let's use this somewhere else. I work on my kitchen, at least for right now. I have a couple of workspaces, but this is currently what's going down. And I think we will. Let's try it on this. Let's see. Let's just kind of mess around on that real quick. I first really want to mix this better. Let's get my sponge. Did I suggest you get like a pack of these sponges? They're generally throwaway, but I like to keep them even when they're all crusty. Pretty handy. I almost think I put too much. I don't want any of that to get on the table. Yeah, I need content. So. Somehow I don't think this is gonna do exactly what I want to do. So I want just enough on there. Water jar filled up, so I'm gonna take these out. These are all dry. I got some of this that'll help. Kind of. I'm just gonna use this blue like as a filler also. Alright. Also, I'm just gonna hold it. Ooh, look at that. I don't want that too much on there. So I'm gonna keep that. Well, this isn't quite what I want. I think I thinned it down too much. Actually, I know I did. At least for this. But when it dries, still want to see what it looks like. Shouldn't take too long for it to dry a little bit. I don't want it to dry around the outside also. This way I kind of know what the ratio is, even though I know they probably tell you. I always fuck things up the first three times anyway. That's why you make a lot of art. Okay, well, now that's gotta sit there and dry. But in the meantime, somehow I think I watered that down way too much. So I'm gonna start over, but not on that piece. I'm just gonna go straight to the where it was before on the other painting. Actually no. give one of these a shot. And this needs to dry. Further. I think we'll go to this. This one we can put on thick. So we'll test that out. Right. First let's read. Okay. Didn't really say. Whatever. I'll just mix. Do a better job of mixing. Plus, that acrylic itself isn't very friendly to mixing. Oh, there's already some in there, which is good. There's still a little bit of water in there too, so that helps. This screen printing ink isn't meant to be mixed well, I don't think. At least not that stuff. That's the kind of mind. I'm just gonna use this, what I was using earlier. Give it a couple shots here. Hey Giraffe, they got Gonky Flakes from the brush itself, but I am just gonna tell people that I put that shit in there and it's make it look like leaves are blowing in the wind. I like that. Boom. say goodbye. Say, call grandma. Post this shit.